Sunday in ordinary time. We would like to welcome in a special way any visitors to our parish. We are glad that you are with us. This Mass is our monthly butterfly Mass, in which we welcome in a special way persons living with disabilities. This evening's Mass is being offered for deceased Marist clergy. Our celebrant this evening will be Father Kevin, assisted by Deacon Bill Kessler. The readings will be found in the gathered hymnal at number 1100-1100. Our entrance hymn will be number 832, In Christ There Is No East or West, number 832. And now please stand and greet those around you.
Special welcome to those living with disabilities and to their families. May you know of our love and support in and through this Eucharist. In today's Gospel passage, we hear that the Spirit of the Lord is with Jesus as he announced a time acceptable to the Lord. Jesus has come into the world precisely to reach out to those in need, to those who struggle in life, and to make God's presence visible and real. He reminds us that God's love has come to fulfillment. So let us prepare our hearts now to celebrate these sacred mysteries by recalling our sins and asking for mercy and for forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you are glad tidings to the poor. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are recovery of sight to the blind. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are God's word among us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
ourselves for a moment of silent prayer. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works. Through our brother Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, Hugh.
A reading from the book of Nehemiah. All the people came together and stood in the open area in front of the water gate. They asked Ezra, the teacher, to read to them from the law of Moses that the Lord had given for his people. So on the first day of the seventh month, Ezra the priest came with the law and stood before the crowd of men and women. Everyone who was able to understand was there. From early morning till noon, Ezra read the law of Moses aloud in front of the water gate. They all listened carefully as Ezra stood and read from the wooden platform that had been built for him. The platform was very high, and everyone could see Ezra as he opened the book of the law. And when he opened it, they all stood up. Ezra praised the wonderful Lord God, and the people shouted, "Amen, amen." They bowed low to the ground and worshiped the Lord. The men who were on the platform with him translated what he read and explained to the people what it meant. Then Nehemiah the governor, Ezra the priest and teacher, and the Levites who had been teaching the people all said, "Don't be sad or cry. This is a special day for the Lord your God." They said this because the people cried when God's law was read to them. Nehemiah told the people, "Enjoy your good food and wine, and share what you have with everyone who didn't have any to bring. Don't be sad. This is a special day for the Lord, and he will make you happy and strong." The word of the Lord.
Of my heart, sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Your words, O Lord, are spirit and life.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the body of Christ has many different parts, just as any other body does. Some of us are Jews and others are Gentiles. Some of us are slaves and others are free. But God's Spirit baptized each of us and made us part of the body of Christ. Now we drink from that same Spirit. Our bodies don't have just one part. They have many parts. Together, you are the body of Christ. Each one of you is part of his body. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, Lord. Jesus returned to Galilee with the power of the Spirit. News about him spread everywhere. He taught in the Jewish meeting places, and everyone praised him. Jesus went back to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And as usual, he went to the meeting place on the Sabbath. When he stood up to read from the scriptures, he was given the book of Isaiah the prophet. He opened it and read, "The Lord's Spirit has come to me because he has chosen me to tell the good news to the poor. The Lord has sent me to announce freedom for prisoners, to give sight to the blind, to free everyone who suffers, and to say, this is the year the Lord has chosen." Jesus closed the book, then handed it back to the man in charge and sat down. Everyone in the meeting place looked straight at Jesus. Then Jesus said to them, "What you have just heard me read has come true today." The Gospel of the Lord.
Jesus makes it pretty clear in today's gospel what his agenda will be. It is his inaugural address, a description of what will characterize his ministry. He will bring glad tidings to the poor, proclaim liberty to captives, sight to the blind, and freedom to the oppressed. With this in mind, it's amazing to me that some people are of the opinion that faith has nothing to do with issues of justice, freedom, poverty. Perhaps there is a reluctance to take the gospel of Jesus seriously and in its entirety. We seem to be able to block out those portions of the scriptures that challenge our prejudices. By focusing on the gap between the world of faith and the real world, we never have to worry about changing our behavior or confronting our culture. However, if we see the gospel for what it is, our roadmap for Christian living, then the words and deeds of Jesus must be seen in a new light. The words of Isaiah spoken by Jesus in Luke's gospel are supposed to be fulfilled in and through Jesus. We make the words of Jesus real when we make our faith real, and when we bring the values of our faith with us into the world. There are many reasons for opposing the death penalty and abortion, many reasons for distributing wealth and power more equitably. But when a Christian opposes murder on death row or in a hospital delivery room, when a Christian proposes service over greed, it's not just a matter of human calculation. For us, it's a matter of faith. It's a matter of whether we really believe the words we've heard and the actions that we see in the life of Jesus, who represents most fully God's will and God's mission. When we reflect on St. Paul's image of the body of Christ, we realize that we all have different roles to play in the life of the church. What part of Christ's body are we? Am I part of his heart, sharing the care of Christ? Am I part of his hands, reaching out to others? Am I part of his feet, taking the gospel with me wherever I go? Am I part of his ears, willingly listening to the anxieties of our culture? Am I part of his lips, speaking the truth? We are people with a mission, and our mission is the work of God's kingdom. A hallmark of Catholic spirituality is that we are led by the Holy Spirit, not simply on a personal spiritual adventure, but we're challenged to further the kingdom of God. This very first sermon of Jesus that we heard today in Nazareth, quoting Isaiah, his mission is to bring liberty, justice, and freedom to people held in bondage in so many ways. Today's readings remind us that the mission of Jesus is our mission. How faithful are we to that mission? May our Eucharist this evening give us strength to be the presence of Jesus. in our world.
Church, especially in this challenging time, that we may be shining witnesses to God's law of love for all people. We pray to the Lord. For the local and national organizations and their efforts to liberate anyone falsely accused and punished, and for the will to resist condemning others by your attitudes, speech, or actions. We pray to the Lord. For our catechists, lectors, and religious education ministers on this Sunday of the Word of God, that they share a greater understanding of the Word of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community, that we may reflect the unity that we are called on to as members of the Christ body, despite our disagreements or conflicts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the Holy Spirit will guide the Church as it prepares for the upcoming Synod of Bishops and the goal of strengthening the Church as we journey together in communion, participation, and mission. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this Deacon Appreciation Weekend, that our deacons will be blessed in their ministries. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing for all in our community experiencing sickness and pain, especially for Michael Kylesberg, Tom Harhay, and all those on our prayer list and book of intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially for those interred in our columbarium, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Continue to pray for the people of the Tongan Island Nations and for our Marist brothers and sisters and fathers who are there. For them we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And in the silence of our hearts, we add our own personal intentions. And for all of these, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together we pray for the intercession. Hail Mary, full of grace,
the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Please be seated.
There is no second collection this weekend.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn, number 708, Set Your Heart on the Higher Bliss. No. number 708.
Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands and the praise and glory of God's name for our good and of all God's holy church.
Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his Passion. He took bread, Almighty Father, and said the blessing. He broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which is given up for you." This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this and remember me.
Thank you.
gift of love and forgiveness to us. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. always glory in your gift through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thanks, Chloe.
We have a lot of announcements. If you would like to receive the sacrament of the sick, please sit in the altar server chairs after Mass. Those are the chairs where Chloe and Hugh are sitting right now. Again, I would like to thank all who are here for our monthly Butterfly Mass, welcoming persons living with disabilities, especially those visiting from other parishes. On a table in the narthex are copies of two books created especially for persons living with disabilities. This Is Your Church helps persons living with disabilities to get to know our church building. I Go to Mass help us and our loved ones better participate in the Mass. If you have questions about the Butterfly Mass or living with disabilities, please see the parishioners in the narthex who are wearing butterfly name tags, appropriately so. I would like to conclude with a beatitude for those with special needs. Do you want to do that or should I?
No, you do it.
Blessed are you when, by all things, you assure us that what makes us individuals is not our particular disability or difficulty, but our beautiful God-given personhood, which no handicapping condition can confine. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for your understanding and love have opened doors for us to enjoy life to its fullest, and you have helped us believe in ourselves as valued and gifted people. Just a reminder, please fill out the survey for the Synod and encourage friends to take the survey as well, and if possible, sign up to attend the listening session on February 12th. See the bulletin or parish website for more information. On this Sunday of the Word of God, I would like now to introduce Elizabeth Piper to say a few words about upcoming religious education courses here at OLA.
Hi, thank you. Each week when we come to Mass, we hear from the writings of our Jewish roots in the Old Testament and from the Gospel, which proclaims the teaching and life of Jesus in the New Testament. In our Gospel reading today, we heard Jesus proclaim his fulfillment of the prophecies from Isaiah. We also know Jesus as the Word made flesh. This Sunday celebrates the Word of God. To help better understand this word, I am here to tell you about an offering for adult faith formation called the Bible Timeline. The Bible Timeline is the story of salvation as it unfolds in the Old Testament and leads us to Jesus in the New Testament. In this revolutionary approach to Bible study, the Bible Timeline divides the Bible into 12 color-coded time periods that make it easier to follow this narrative thread. And you get this worksheet here, timeline here. Using a unique color-coded chart, you will learn the majority of people, places, and events of the Bible and discover how they all come together to reveal the remarkable story of our faith. We will meet weekly on Wednesdays in the morning from 8:30 to 10 in the upper room starting on January 26th, or in the evening in the parish office conference room from 7 to 8:30 starting February 2nd. Let me know you are coming either after Mass or by emailing me. For more information, please see the bulletin. I hope you can all come. Thank you.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
As was mentioned in the Prayer of the Faithful, it's Deacon Appreciation Weekend. I wish we could have a parade or maybe a keg party. I guess I've been working with college students too long. But let's suffice it with an applause and our love and our gratitude to our deacons.
Be with you. And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Have a great weekend, a great Sunday, everyone.